Kelly, thank you. And Governor Cuomo did announce today a change in the pandemic rules for people visiting loved ones at nursing homes.
The rule change should make it a bit easier for nursing home visitors. But as Steve Brown reports, the biggest hurdle to nursing home visits remains in place.
Because senior citizens are the most susceptible to COVID-19, there are lots of rules for people who want to visit loved ones inside of nursing homes. One rule requires all visitors to have proof of a negative COVID test within 7 days of the visit. Governor Andrew Cuomo today announced a change to that rule that his state health department,
which is going to recommend that visitors take a rapid test before entry, and DOH will provide those rapid tests to nursing homes cost free.
That's one less hurdle for Diane Johnson. She says her 93-year-old aunt is her best friend. Johnson asked us not to disclose the aunt's name, but did provide images for us to share with you. The aunt lives at Heritage Manor, an assisted living facility in Lockport. For 3+ months, the aunt has not had visitors. It is a state and federal requirement that facilities have 14 consecutive days of no new COVID cases before allowing visitors in. That hasn't happened here since before Thanksgiving. Johnson says she desperately misses her thrice weekly outings with her aunt.
So when I take her out, she says to me, "We're in a happy mode today." You know, because I'm always a little distressed over her lack of being able to get out.
Johnson tells Two on Your Side the outings with her aunt included regular trips to the salon to get her hair done.
You feel good?
Yeah, it's amazing what your hair does to you.
Yeah, say hello to Pam and Wendy and Kathy.
Hi, girls. Hi, girls.
Doesn't she look beautiful?
But while rapid testing removes one hurdle between nursing home residents and their loved ones, the big one still remains. And that is the rule on no new COVID cases inside of a facility for 14 straight days. A state health department official tells me that is the guidance from the CDC, and that will remain the rule here in New York State. That sadly is also the biggest hurdle Diane Johnson has between her and her 93-year-old aunt. In Buffalo, Steve Brown, Channel 2 News.